A thriller in Chicago, the Blue Demon.
Nurses all gathered round, and they gazed in wide wonder at the joy they had found. The head nurse spoke up, said, "Leave this one alone." She could tell right away that I was bad to the bone, bad to the bone, bad to the bone, bad, bad, bad. The bone. I broke a thousand hearts before I met you. I'll break a thousand more, baby, before I am through. I want to be yours, pretty baby, yours and yours alone. I'm here to tell you, honey, that I'm bad to the bone, bad to the bone. Every woman I meet, they all stay satisfied. I want to tell you, pretty baby, when I see I make my own. And I'm here to tell you, honey, that I'm bad to the bone, bad to the bone. Bad to the bone.
DePaul basketball 1994-95. This year's Blue Demon team will be remembered for one thing, toughness. It was another successful year on the court, 17 wins and another postseason berth. But what set this DePaul team apart, they played with everybody. And everybody that played them knew they'd been in a game.
A lot of teams, you know, midseason are playing okay, and they kind of deteriorate when they get into tough times because the base isn't good, the chemistry isn't good, they don't get along real well, and the more adversity they meet, the more they pull apart. This team, the more adversity they met, they seemed to pull together and fight a little bit harder, and then that's what made this team get better.
In only their second game of the year, DePaul faced the toughest of tasks, Georgetown at Georgetown. And although the Demons fell just short of victory, this team showed they'd be a force in the year ahead. In that game, freshman Jermaine Watts burst onto the scene, ironically, with a basket he didn't even make. Watts' explosive near dunk in the face of the Hoyas let the basketball world know that a future star was born. Watts went on to average 4 points a game during the season and was one of the team's assist leaders. More importantly, though, was the flair in which he played. Jermaine Watts is a talent, and soon his name will be mentioned with the great DePaul point guards of the past. After the Georgetown loss, DePaul rolled to 5 straight wins, including victories over Notre Dame at the United Center and a 35-point shellacking of Northwestern at the Horizon. A 6-2 start with the meat of their schedule lying in wait. Marcus Singer was DePaul's bomber off the bench in 95. The 6'6 sophomore drained 29 three-pointers, including 5 in one game. Singer played in every game in 95 and once again showed his unmatched enthusiasm, in the game or not. Dwayne Austin once again came on late for the Blue Demons. He saw action in the last 6 games of the regular season and provided his usual quickness, spark, and 3-point shooting to aid the Demon attack.
Listen as your day unfolds, challenge what the future holds, try and keep your head up to the sky.
Near midseason, DePaul faced a crossroad. With the heart of their schedule staring them in the face, it would be a stretch that could make or break the season. The odyssey began in California, Santa Barbara's nut house of a gym and ESPN's Big Monday. usually a deadly combination for visitors. DePaul, well, the Demons responded with one of their best performances of the season, an 80-62 washout that let a national television audience know that DePaul could play anywhere with anybody.
I think we played a hell of a game that day, considering, you know, the crowd was, they have one of the largest and craziest crowds in the nation. It was a great feeling going on their home floor and beating them.
After the win over UCSB, DePaul 3 days later was in Texas. Another ESPN audience and another power in the Longhorns awaited. The Blue Demons played a dazzling first half, racing out to a 17-point lead. In the end, however, fatigue won out as Texas prevailed 99-92 in a double overtime thriller. 2 days later, DePaul was back in Chicago for a date with Marquette at the United Center. The Golden Eagles were a Sweet 16 team the previous year, but on this date, DePaul, with their bags probably still unpacked, cruised to a 62-48 win.
It just started clicking a little bit, and they started understanding more and more what their roles were, and I was real pleased how well we were playing at the end of the year.
The Marquette win began a string of six consecutive wins, including a last-second thriller over St. Louis at the Horizon.
Down the six. Nice pass, man. Whoa! Wow, what an excellent, excellent ball game.
DePaul handed the Billikens a rare loss, 66-64, a foreshadowing of future Horizon dramatics. Peter Patton started every game at point guard for the Blue Demons, leading the team and the Great Midwest in three-point field goal percentage. When Patton shot, he usually hit. The junior scored 15 points at Texas and 16 in a win over St. Joe's. Patton once again showed the fiery spirit that makes him one of college basketball's fiercest competitors. Brian Curry showed signs of brilliance in his junior season. Curry hit the game winner against St. Louis and scored a career-high 12 points against Marquette. But Brian Curry made his mark by displaying the skills that make him DePaul's finest athlete. Malik Murray played in 11 games as a junior, and of those games, he scored in four. Malik continued to improve as the season progressed and could see more playing time as a Blue Demon senior. Ryan Bowden anchored the middle for the Blue Demons in 95. Big Bo put up numbers nearly as big as himself. Bowden averaged 12 points a game, ranking in the top 10 in three categories in the Great Midwest. Bryant was the team's third leading rebounder and twice during the season led the team in scoring. As the regular season drew to a close, DePaul faced Louisville at the Horizon. A CBS television audience looked on as the Demons and Cardinals battled for a postseason tournament bid. What ensued was quite possibly one of the greatest games ever on the Horizon floor. Down the stretch, Brian Bowden's three straight baskets kept DePaul close, but with only seconds remaining, the Demons trailed by three. They needed a miracle. Enter Tom Kleinschmidt.
Joey Meyer has the play called for his young team, and it's going to be Kleinschmidt, the senior.
And he got fouled! He got fouled on a three!
Senior Tom Kleinschmidt's four-point play gave DePaul an 82-81 win, providing one of the most dramatic victories in school history.
That's just a feeling I don't remember. I mean, you only get that maybe once in your life. And for me to have it here on national TV against such a good team, and to have the, you know, us win, that was so special for me.
Those are the greatest feelings ever. I mean, the emotions of that, you know, it just, you're so happy, it make tears come to your eyes. You know, you work so hard, you know, to get there, and then to even pull it out like that is just incredible.
John Brusick and John Harris ended their four-year DePaul careers as scholarship athletes. These two, for 4 years, were the Blue Demons' practice superstars. And on the court, they made their mark as well. Harris, in his final home game, had a steal and a hoop. And as for the Bruiser, his claim to fame was outscoring All-American Othello Harrington in a Blue Demon win his junior year.
It was just fun to watch them develop and mature as people, how much they contributed to the program. And now, when we didn't have that many people on scholarship, they were integral parts of practice, not just guys that stand on the sideline. They were a real big part of our team this year.
Brandon Cole wrapped up his DePaul career as one of the school's all-time greats. Cole's name will be permanently displayed across the Blue Demon record book, and including the team's career leader in three-point field goals. Brandon in 95 put up some tremendous numbers, including a career-high 32 points and 10 rebounds in his final home game against Dayton. Cole ranked in the top 10 in four categories in the Great Midwest and was the league's leading free throw shooter.
Brandon's one of the quicker players I've ever coached. Unbelievable quickness and a toughness about him. He wasn't a vocal leader, but he was a hard-nosed son of a gun. You know, everybody looked at him, he looked as thin as a rail, but he was a very tough, hard-nosed player.
Will Macon spent 2 years in a Blue Demon uniform and was a major factor both seasons. Will responded from an injury-plagued junior year to become a mainstay on the Demons' front line in 95. Macon averaged 10 points and 9 rebounds a game as a senior while starting every game. Will scored a career-high 19 points against Eastern Illinois, and against Marquette, he set a Great Midwest record, grabbing 21 rebounds.
Somebody I enjoyed coaching. That's what I'll probably remember the most. I enjoyed coaching because of his enthusiasm, his will to win, and his unselfishness was something that I always remember.
Tom Kleinschmidt quite simply ended his career as one of DePaul's all-time greatest players. Kleinschmidt, 95, averaged 21 points a game, leading DePaul in both scoring and assists. Kleinschmidt is the only player in DePaul history to rank in the top 10 in career scoring, assists, and steals, and joined Mark McGuire as the only Blue Demon to have three 500-point scoring seasons. In 95, Tom was named the Great Midwest Player of the Year and Associated Press All-American.
I'll be very surprised if you don't talk to a DePaul person, alumni who followed DePaul, that will not list Tom Kleinschmidt as one of the greats that played at DePaul. I think you can mention his name with all those players.
For DePaul's three seniors, their careers come to a close with not only unforgettable moments and dramatic wins, they leave DePaul with memories that will last a lifetime.
Meeting the friends that I met while I was here, the players that I played with, it was a great experience to me.
That'll carry, you know, that'll be with me for as long as I can remember, you know, just the relationship I had with some of these guys on the team, plus the staff, and you know, we worked hard all the time and we did the best we could.
There were words left unsaid and things left undone, but we just seem to run out of time. But I feel you out there, just as warm as the sun, and I hold you so close in my mind.
Ended the year with 17 wins and a postseason tournament berth for the 17th time in the last 18 years.
You have a satisfaction, and in coaching, my satisfaction comes in knowing that these players are developing, getting better, and are reaching their potential. And this team, I always think teams could get better, but this team came as close to being as good as it could be as any team I've ever coached.
Your love.